Hi, welcome back to Caribbean J. Today I will be preparing a chicken and brown rice soup. Let's go into the kitchen with me and do some cooking. Okay guys, we have the carrots already done. We're doing the potato next. Close to medium size, guys. You dice the potatoes. We try to dice everything close to medium size. This one is small, so we're just gonna put that one right there. And the potatoes are done. Celery next. Okay, did the celery. Now I'm gonna do the onions. I started the onions already. Okay, guys. We're starting our chicken soup, and I'm using some olive oil, about a tablespoon or 2 tablespoons, that's about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Okay guys, here I'm using 3 leg quarters. Normally a lot of people use chicken breasts. That's not my cup of tea, so I'm using the leg quarters, and I have rotisserie chicken that I will be using. Okay, I'm browning my chicken just a little bit, not too brown. because it's the soup, so I just need to just like give it a little bit of color, you know what I mean? Yep. And a beautiful. I wish if you guys could smell this. Now we're gonna start to add all the good stuff in here. Add the potatoes. Let's do a pinch a little bit, and then I'm going to add the broth in the chicken broth in there. Remember guys, the chicken already seems ready, so I'm trying. I don't want to overseas it, and I don't want to put too much sauce in there either.
Okay guys, I'm going to stir I'm going to stir my pack of salad so I can take everything inside my pack.
And then I'm gonna add my chicken broth. It's 8 cups of chicken broth. And the rest will be water. So for some unknown reason, the portion where I was adding the chicken broth, that did not record. I don't know why. Okay guys, the brown rice portion did not get recorded either. Already in the pot now. I'm stirring it up and add some water in there. So I'm gonna stir it up and then I'm gonna leave it to boil to bring it to a good boil for at least a good 45 minutes or so, especially because the brown rice is already in there. Starving, you know, cover girls eat nothing, she says. Okay, for my vegetarian followers, you can substitute the chicken broth with the low sodium vegetable broth, and also substitute the meat with the button mushroom cut in quarters, or you can use tofu.
Okay guys, I have some rotisserie chicken that we had bought, and we had some stuff left over, so I'm gonna add this in here. This is for more flavor. Add some. rice already cooked. Oh, I have a couple bay leaves in here too. You'll see them floating around here. This is part of the rotisserie chicken that I cut up and just chopped it up in one place. This is a whole lot of flavor, guys. A whole lot of flavor. Don't forget, guys, if you're vegetarian, you can use mushrooms, the button mushrooms, or you can use a tofu, a firm tofu, for substitute for the meat, and vegetable broth. I use chicken broth. Meat lover, thank you very much. Or you can use a low sodium vegetable broth. Put your stuff in there, and yeah, especially now that it's cold, we'll be doing a whole lot of soups, guys. I have some stews also that I'll be making. See that brown rice? Look at that, guys. Doesn't that look good? Let me let it cook, bring it to a good boil again, and that will be the story. Don't forget, guys, don't forget to subscribe, tap the bell so you don't miss any of my other videos, and don't forget to give me a thumbs up. I appreciate that. Oh, I also add some spice to it. You know, not like a good hot cup of spice of chicken soup. Let's just put this in there. Bring it to a good boil, and we're done. Okay. Put some in a little dish, and we're gonna go and taste it. Okay, guys, let's taste this soup. Oh my God, this is good. The brown rice. Oh my God, this is good. I think you need a little bit more spice. I need to add hot. Put a hot sauce to this. Just a little bit of kick. I guess that's for everybody's choice, huh?
But I can make it explode. This is my fight.